The string of devastating storms which hit the Philippines in October and November pushes inflation to a 21-month high. The 3.3% November inflation rate was also higher than the Philippine Central Bank's forecast for the period of up to 3.2% inflation. Prices of vegetables, meat, and fish all surged after the storms affected agricultural supply chains across Luzon. National statistician Undersecretary Dennis Mapa says the lingering effects of the African swine fever was also to blame for high meat inflation. He is still unsure how long this spike in inflation will last.
What we will do, we will track itong three commodity items and as a food basket, vegetables, meat, and fish. Kadalasan yung vegetables kasi, unless may mga damages tayo sa crops, supply lang naman yung pag-deliver, pagkatapos ng storm, normally nakikita naman natin na mayroong pagbaba sa presyo.
But Philippine Central Bank Governor Benjamin Diokno believes the inflation spike is temporary and overall inflation won't exceed their target range of between 2 and 4%. The central bank cut its key interest rate to a record low of 2% in November, and it will hold its final monetary policy meeting of 2020 on December 17th. Diokno has not hinted at any further policy action and has in fact said that the monetary board has done more than enough to stoke the economy. For RCBC chief economist Michael Ricafort, higher inflation would certainly limit Diokno's options for now. Ricafort, however, believes the fiscal stimulus program of the Duterte economic team can do enough to boost the recovery. He says new laws to cut corporate income taxes will give a definite boost to the private sector, valued at 40 billion pesos in the first year of the law once it is passed, and over 600 billion for the next years. On Thursday, the Development Budget Coordination Committee cut its growth outlook for 2020 again to between -8.5% and -9.5%. That would be the worst contraction on record based on data going back to the 1940s. But the lower forecast was not enough to convince Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez to increase the government's spending plan. For Moody's Investor Service, the Philippines is actually doing well if you judge it by its inflation. But the country's economy is still in a rough position.
Inflation will be somewhat limited for the next couple of years. You know, the COVID-19 is really in a sense, a deflationary event because of the weakness in demand. Many producers simply have very little pricing power. There will be a little bit of pickup in demand going forward, but the recovery in the economy will be kind of a slow slog, a slow process over the next couple of years.
The Philippines has the highest inflation rate among major ASEAN economies. It also had the worst GDP growth rate in the third quarter, with a contraction of 11.5%. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.